Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and Apple released iOS 13.1.1. This is available to all devices that support iOS 13 and is available to the public. It is not a beta. So you'll be able to install this if you have iOS 13 or newer. And then also, it's available for not only iPhones, but also iPads. So iPads move over to iPadOS 13.1.1 also. All of the same fixes are included for both. Now, I had a very difficult time installing this. In fact, it only installed easily on my iPhone XR and 8 Plus and came in at 112.4 megabytes on my iPhone XR. But in order to get it installed on my iPhone 11 Pro Max and iPhone XS Plus, I actually had to use iTunes to do it. I could not get it to install over the air, and also had to actually install the file separately using the IPSW file. There's something wrong with the update. I tried all sorts of different networks. I tried rebooting the phone, restarting it, trying different networks. You name it, I've tried it, and it just didn't work. But let's go ahead and take a look at the build number. The build number is 17A854. And with this particular build, or the actual update number being 13.1.1 being three digits out, they're normally small bug fixes or small security fixes. However, Apple has actually patched some pretty significant things in this particular update. However, the first thing you need to know is that there is no new modem firmware. So if you have an older device that you're having issues with connectivity-wise, Apple has not patched the modem firmware. However, with the iOS 13 updates, 13, 13.1, and now 13.1.1, I find that connectivity is much, much better. So if you're still having an issue, you may want to try and reset your phone. Normally, it seems that it's much better for most people. Not everyone, but most. Now, there are six significant fixes with this particular update, and the first one has to do with restoring an iPhone. In fact, Apple has said that maybe you're restoring from an older phone to a newer phone, such as the iPhone 8 Plus that I have here, maybe to a new iPhone 11 Pro Max or something like that, any of the old phones to a new phone or vice versa. It fixes an issue that could prevent the iPhone from restoring from a backup. So that should be patched now. If you are having issues, you should be able to restore. It also addresses an issue that could cause battery drain to be much quicker than it was before. So maybe with iOS 13.1, you notice significant battery drain. They should have patched that now. So if I go on to my 11 Pro Max, I'm still getting used to that name, but 11 Pro Max, you'll see here's my battery over the past few days with iOS 13.1. It wasn't bad at all, and the battery life on iOS 13.1 for me was fine. However, some people were having significant battery drain, and the battery is so good on the 11 Pro Max, and I'll mention that in my review, that I don't really notice if there's battery drain. So you'll see 5 hours and 57 minutes of screen on time with a lot of battery life left. It just depends on the day, but it could be draining fast, and if it is, this fixes it for you. It also fixes an issue specific to the iPhone 11, 11 Pro, and 11 Pro Max, and that is the recognition of Siri requests. So maybe you're talking to your phone using Siri, and it's not understanding you. It should better understand you now. So hopefully that's better. I haven't had too many issues, but apparently some people have. Now, it also resolves an issue where maybe you went into your settings, and then you went to Safari. We'll go down to Safari here, and then the Safari search suggestions, maybe it's something you don't like to use with Siri and search. You'll see show Siri suggestions in apps. And if we go to Safari here, and let's get off of this page, we've got suggestions down here. Maybe you disabled this. Well, it would re-enable itself. So they've fixed that. So it will no longer do that. It also addresses an issue where if you use the Reminders app and it was syncing, it could sync really slowly. And I've seen this personally when I set up a new phone. It took forever to sync some of these, and they're just simple text files. So that should be resolved. It should sync much, much faster. Now, the last thing they've fixed has to do with a huge security hole that they actually mentioned when iOS 13.1 came out, and that is an issue with third-party keyboards. Maybe you're using Gboard or some other keyboard app. It had full access to the whole system, and it should not have that, and they've actually patched it. That was a pretty big security hole, and Apple actually said they were going to patch that pretty quickly, so they've done that now. So overall, it's a pretty solid update, but there's not a whole lot new in it. You don't expect any new icons or anything like that significant. There may be little tweaks here and there to where pixel placements are and things like that, but overall, it's mostly a bug fix. And specifically the battery, I think, is going to interest most people. Battery is something I hear about regularly from many of you saying that you're hoping for better battery. And this hopefully will really, really improve battery. I think battery in iOS 13 is decent, but many people complained with iOS 12.4, 12.4.1. Hopefully we see significant gains. Now, speed overall, on the oldest devices I have here, well, the iPhone XR isn't old, but I've been using the XR quite a bit today, and also the 8 Plus, and the speed seems fine. It seems very fast. I've had no stutters, no lag. If I go into settings, now this is not an old device. Oh, just stuttered there for just a second, a frame rate drop, but overall, it's very fast. And all of these same updates carry across to the iPad. So if you have iPad OS running, it's all the same. You'll have the same fixes with the exception of the one for Siri that's specific to the new iPhones. Now let's take a look at the Geekbench scores. We're going to run them on the iPhones here since I don't have all the iPads updated. And like I said, I've had some issues with the update, but I am going to use Geekbench 5 since this is the standard going forward. Even though the numbers are a little bit lower, if you want to compare yourself to the Geekbench standards or the numbers, make sure you're using Geekbench 5. Now we'll go ahead and open this and you'll see I ran Geekbench on the iPhone 11 Pro Max and scored a single core score of 1,331. I received 3,503 for the multi-core score. If we take a look at the history, we're actually a little bit better when it comes to the single core and multi-core, not by a ton, but a little bit. Now, as far as the other devices, let's go ahead and lay them out here so we can take a look. So we'll take a look at the 8 Plus and the XR. On the left, you can see I have the iPhone 8 Plus. In the middle is the iPhone 11 Pro Max. And on the right is the iPhone XR. So hopefully this gives you a general idea of what your scores should be if you're using similar devices. If they're a little bit higher or a little bit lower, that's completely normal. Now, if you haven't installed this update yet, or you're considering installing it, I would highly recommend it since it fixes many of the major issues and security issues that we've had with iOS 13. And hopefully it restores touch sensitivity to the iPad Pro line. Sometimes it's just not responsive. Even with 13.1, it just wouldn't react. I'd have to actually lock it, unlock it, and then it would work again. So hopefully it fixes it. It seems good so far, but we won't know for a few days. And let me know if you want me to do a follow-up on iOS 13.1 still. Since we're past that, I'd like to move on to 13.1.1 and do a separate poll. But let me know what you think about that in the comments below. That's it for iOS 13.1.1. If you had difficulty installing it, I would love to hear from you. Did you get it installed? Did you have to use iTunes, or did it just work for you without a problem? Let me know in the comments below. I tried everything from resetting the phones, different networks, you name it, I tried it and it just didn't work. But if you'd like to get your hands on the wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description as I always do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and hit that notification bell if you'd like to see more of these videos as soon as they're released. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.